So let's start with arrays. So arrays are basically just lists, ordered lists of things, and you can put anything in an array that you want in JavaScript. In other programming languages, everything in an array has to be the same type. In JavaScript, you can put anything in an array. You can mix types to your heart's content. And in some other languages, you have to declare the size of the array before you can start using it. In JavaScript, it's pretty flexible and you can add stuff to arrays as you need to. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a constant array called values. And let's go ahead and put the number 0 and the number 1 and the string 0 and the string 1. And then let's put not a number, infinity, and minus infinity, null, undefined. And let's go ahead and put an empty object, which we'll learn about in the next video. And let's put another empty object. So these are actually two different objects. And then we're going to put an empty array and another empty array. And now let's put an array that has some stuff in it. And let's put an object that has some stuff in it. Might not be spelled correctly, but so there's an object. And then let's go ahead and add console and console.log and document and document.write. So those are most of the values that we used for our cheat sheet in week 2. But here, instead of hard coding all that HTML, which was kind of awkward, and embedding all those script islands, here we're actually going to use this array of values to generate a cheat sheet. And you might want to integrate this into your existing cheat sheet or copy some stuff over from there. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a function that generates an HTML table, and then we're going to store that inside of a div box on the main page. So we're going to need somewhere to dock, and I'm going to go ahead and add a H2. So here's my types, and here's a div box with an ID equal type table. And that's where I'm going to store a type table. So let's go ahead and create a function that generates a type table. And let's just start with table equals table. And then we're going to add generate header. And then we're going to go through this list of values, and for each value in this array, we're going to add a table row. So for var counter equals 0, counter less than values dot length, counter plus plus, we're going to do something. And what we're going to do is table plus equal generate type row, and then we're going to pass in values sub counter. So on the first time through this loop, counter will be 0, and we're going to get values sub 0, which is going to be this first value. On the second time through the loop, we'll get values sub 1, which is the second value, then values sub 2, and so on. And actually, let me call this generate type header. And after we've added all of the rows to our table, let's go ahead and close off the table. And I'm going to format this a little bit just so that it's a little better to look at. So we'll add a carriage return new line to the end there, and we'll add a carriage return new line to the end there. And then for each row, we're going to go ahead and we're going to indent two spaces. And for the header, we're going to go ahead and indent two spaces. So let's go ahead and generate the type header. And actually, for consistency, I should do that as well. So the header is going to be a row, and I'm just going to hard code this for now. So return a piece of text. It's a table row, and it's got a table header. And we're going to put the value. And for now, let's just go ahead and put the type. And we're going to add some more stuff to this later on. And then to generate a row, this is going to take a parameter. And this is going to generate a table row, table data. And then we want to convert this value to a piece of text. And that's actually a little complicated, but we're going to have the tools we need to do this the right way this time around. So I'm going to call a function called string value, which I'm going to write. So that's our first value. And then our second value is going to be type of value. And then we're going to close off our cell and close off our row and add a carriage return new line. So for string value, what I'm going to do right now to keep it simple is I'm just going to take the value and return it. So that's what you would get if you were to just write the value as is. So I think we have enough here. Let's go ahead and I'm going to save it and reload. And I have an unexpected token, so I'm going to click on that in the console. I was writing an array and somehow I got confused. So let's go ahead and take a look at here. So I started an array, and then by the time I got to the end, I forgot that I was making an array. So now it's an array. And this is an assignment statement, which is why I put a semicolon at the end there. Good. Okay, so everything loaded correctly. And now if I go to console, I should be able to execute generate type table and call that. Oh, and I need to return the value. Return table and reload and call it. Good, so there's my table. And then if I wanted to display that, I would say document.get element by ID, and then I think I called it type table. And I'm going to set the inner HTML to generate type table. So there it is. There's my type table. Not very pretty yet, but we're going to fix that. So I have a little problem here. If you look at the HTML, I have a close tag and another close tag. That should be an open tag. So let's go to type row, fix that. And execute that again. There we go. So that's looking a little better. And I think I want to center these. So I'm going to center all of my table cells and my table header. And I'm going to use CSS to do that. So let's go back to my week5.html. And I'll move this into a separate file later on. But for now, I'm just going to go style. And for the TD, I'm going to go text align center. And let's actually create a style for TH as well. And I might want to do some separate markup for that, so I'm going to create a separate style. And let's go ahead and reload and execute. Good. Okay, so that's looking a little better. Now, what I'm going to do here is in my JavaScript, I'm going to basically do the same thing in my init function. Actually, let's just copy that line here. There. All right, so let's see what we have. We have 0 and 1 are numbers. Double quoted 0 and double quoted 1 are strings, not a number, infinity, and so on. Now, what I'm going to do next is I'm going to start working on this string value a little bit, but I'm going to do that in a separate video.